Oh, I'm getting some Streets of Rage vibes from this guy. With those fucking Sonic shoes. Inverted Sonic shoes. Do I need my controller for this? I feel like I do. I feel like this is a very... Let me put my controller in again. I feel like I might need it. Oh yeah, definitely. 100% a Streets of Rage game. Oh yeah. It even has the Street Bugs. Hell yeah, dude. They just changed the- Wow. Right down to the throw. If there's a cake in here, I swear to God. Oh, this is such a rip. This is such a rip. I love it. I fucking love it. Yeah, 100% this is a ripoff of Streets of Rage, and I love it. I love it a lot. Yep, here we go. Oh, shit! I swear to God. If this big guy breathes fire, I'm done. Don't think I don't remember your ass. Oh shit. Hubba. I didn't see that one. Oh, here's Bubba. Fuck you, Bubba. Damn, dude. They make the baseball bats look like they fucking hurt in this. Aw, yep. Why'd I do that? Why did I eat that? Baseball bats are literally the ones from Streets of Rage. I love this. Who made this game? I fucking love this already. Ha ha ha! Oh. Hello? Wait, no, the game! Oh. Okay. That's fucking cool. Look at the pixel work. Holy shit, man. Welcome to Suburbia. This is fucking great. Hybit Studios. All right, I'm ready. I'm ready for this. Oh yeah, I'm a sucker for pixel cityscapes. Any kind of pixel art, I'm a sucker for. Oh, is that our guy? Is that our man?
There I was, up in my room, just like every other night, counting taillights on the highway. Soon the cars below would reach the city. But me, I'd still be here, stuck in sleepy suburbia. Or so I thought. But sometimes extraordinary things will happen if you just let them.
I'm digging this music though, for real, for really, for real. This is right up my 80s alley. As kid. Alright. Cool. That is super cool. So I got this also in a Humble Bundle, and I have no idea what it's about. The trailer looked amazing, and I was like, what the hell is this? So I decided to go ahead and play it now. I've had it for a while, but I decided now is the time. Like, why the fuck not? I have too many games that I just don't play that I have, and it's like, I might as well at least take a peek at the intro, at the very least, to see what's up. This is so good. Look at this. This is so well done.
Welcome to Suburbia.
Yeah, the music
just
is kicking,
dude.
Just outside
the city. Sometime in 1980X. What you see around here used to be all that I cared for. Because it was all that I knew. It was here that I'd met my first friends, rode my first bike, found my first love, and found out that nothing lasts forever. This is the place I grew up in and grew out of. A place I loved and hated. I remember walking around these blocks for hours, just waiting for something to happen. I knew I needed to move forward. But every day felt like I was on a road to nowhere. The same office buildings and cheap restaurants, the grocery store, the laundromat, and the video rental place where Dad used to take me on the weekends. He'd be looking for classics, while I was more into superheroes. Oh man, we could go on forever. But then, We didn't go there anymore. It was no big deal. These days, I guess I was just looking for anything that could make my heart skip a beat again. And that was when I found it.
God, I love the art in this. Holy shit.
The factory was built long before I was born, but had been shut down and abandoned for as long as I could remember. Mom used to tell me to stay away from there, but there was something down that pitch black alley that caught my eye. It took all the guts I had to go down the stairs. The basement air was thick with cigarette smoke and 10,000 volts of energy. And in the midst of this electric haze stood an army of high-tech creatures, their huge crystal-clear screens flashing before my eyes.
Oh, hell yeah, dude!
I've seen video games before. Dad even brought home one black and white model when I was really young. But this was something else. Something you could not take home with you. And this place was definitely no hangout for children. In front of these machines stood some of the coolest, uncool people I had ever seen. They were the freaks, geeks, the misfits, the outcasts, the real rebels, part of something the outside world could not understand or even knew existed. These guys were all playing trance-like, totally absorbed, as if they experienced something from another dimension.
I'm fucking here for this.
Maybe I could be one of them.
Oh God, the font. Oh man. Are we just gonna be playing different arcade games? I'm here for this, if that's the case. I'm fucking here for it. Out of the void. Yo! This is so good. I don't even want to press start yet. I love this shit. What the fuck? The music is so good. Everything is so good. Yeah, I thought it was a beat 'em up. I was gonna accept it. But this is, oh shit. Hell yeah. I am not good at shooters, but fuck it. Played my fair share of Galaga, but you know, bullet holes are not my thing. We'll see. Do I get a retry? I do. Hey, buddy. I know, right? This music.
Get ready.
Oh, Yeah. Is this a refuel? Oh no, these are vines. Okay. I thought it was a refuel. I was thinking afterburner. Am I supposed to attack this? Oh, I am. Whoa. Start over from the beginning. Oh, okay. That's pretty generous, honestly, to start from the boss. I thought it was gonna be like old school. Start from the goddamn beginning. Oh shit, we're not done. To you, fuck it. This is the most generous arcade game. Oh, it's a one shot? Damn! Okay, fuck. I guess that's why they made it. Before Gaby continues with all your shit, because, that ain't no joke. It's a one shot. Oh no! I might not be able to make this one, y'all. I might just have to do it like this. Take damage. My fingies hurt so bad. My fingies. Whoa, fuck! My fingies. Aw, oh, come on, man. Aw. Oh. There we go. Using my index finger now, fuck it. Damn it! Okay, I see where I'm supposed to be aiming, but I'm trying to goof it. There we go. Oh, we're not done? Phase two?
It wouldn't be fair to say I didn't do my best in school. At least for a while, I really tried to make it work. But now, walking those hallways with all those people, I wasn't really there. I was on an asteroid somewhere, fighting space invaders. But then there was her. Punk rocker from the Southern District. She was the wildest thing I'd ever seen. Oh man, that girl was born a rebel. Free to go wherever she wanted to. Free in a way I could still only dream of.
Trying to wait for the intro. Oh god, I'm getting some serious fucking burnout vibes. Oh god, I have serious burnout vibes right now. Oh no, I was never good at this game. Oh, do they not have the thing if you turn too much it goes? Do they not have that in this? Oh, there it is. So, I don't know how familiar you guys are with Sega Genesis, but there was a, there was this game, or I guess a pack of games called Six Pack. That's 6-PAK. And a lot of these games are coming from that shit. A lot of them. Not all of them, but a lot of these games are coming from that. And I super appreciate that. Like, I get people who get, like, the nostalgia for Nintendo and all that, and that's cool. But I actually never had anything Nintendo growing up until the Wii U. And I didn't really understand that it was its own console for a long time. I think my parents tried to keep it from me because it was so expensive back then. So they were like, we're not losing money with this bullshit. So they just gave me a Sega and called it a day. Your little green car just ran me the fuck over. But yeah, so when people have, you know, nostalgia for like Contra and Legend of Zelda and all this shit, like, it's only a nostalgia I could probably, you know, maybe dream of having, because I've never played those games before until, you know, the Wii U stage, and even then I've only played the you know, the new age version of shit. I'm not gonna make it. So you're a Sonic kid? Yeah. My sister beat Sonic the Hedgehog on her own multiple times. Sonic 1 and 2. And I think she said she liked 2 better than 1. I don't know how, but she did it. I could not beat that shit for the life of me. But then again, I was like 8 years her junior, so she probably understood how to play video games better than I did, you know, than a little goofy-ass 8-year-old sister. But I had all the shit. I had, my dad got me Afterburner, because he was a big plane guy. Big jet plane guy. So any flying fighters he was into, like, what was the game that he used to play? It was on the PC, and I used to think it was kind of scary. Hellbender! He used to play Hellbender on the PC, and I used to play Afterburner with him. I think it was a co-op game. So we would play Afterburner 2 together. And there was Return of Shinobi. Streets of Rage was the big thing with me. I love Streets of Rage. I never beat it, but I loved it to death, and I still do. But, that, Golden Axe, what else did I play now? You know, for it to be such a small amount of games, I played a fuck ton of games on the Sega Genesis, now that I'm thinking about it. I had a lot of weird games, and, you know, besides the six-pack, I had, you know, of course, my mom would find stuff like, the Nickelodeon games, like Aw Real Monsters was a thing, the Tiny Toons Adventures game. Which was, I'd have to revisit it to see if that was actually a really good game or if that was actually just, you know, not that great, but, Lion King, I beat Lion King like 10 times, once, twice in a row, because I had that shit down pat when I was a kid. I tried it again in my older years, maybe a couple of years ago, with a totally legit, Sega Genesis. And, it took me a minute to beat that motherfucker. Like, I knew how. Like, it was almost like muscle memory. Like, I know how to do it. It's just actually doing it. That's the problem. Don't run me over. I'm so not good at these frickin'. The next one. Where is it? 5, 4. Did I make it? Oh, this is beautiful. Look at this. Holy fuck, man. You sucked at the Lion King. It was hard. It was fucking difficult. Like, anybody who says that they were bad at it, like, don't even feel bad. That shit was fucking hard. Like, the I just want to be king level? Oh my god, that used to throw me through a loop until I got that down. Shit was so unfair.
I started hanging out in the arcade almost every night.
Toga87, thank you for the follow. Welcome to the Queendom.
Standing there beside the other players, watching every move their fingers made. This was the real thing. Another life was just one credit away. Down here, I found new worlds and new meaning. I could be whoever I wanted to be. Travel to outer space, experience fantasy and fear, or just take a walk on the wild side of town. But nothing could beat the rush of the highway. The speeding cars reminding me that there was a way out, a road to somewhere. City on the horizon. I'd drive all night to get to that place.
I'm entranced by this fucking game right now. This is amazing. Fucking amazing. Uh-oh. Ain't pay attention though. The music is so good. It's so good. Can I just be in the fast lane? Wait. Can I just be in the fast lane and be good? Oh, then hell yeah. We're cruising.
Just about the escape. It was about transformation. For every visit I made, every game I uncovered, every move I mastered, I felt stronger, more confident. Some guy said I was nothing but a dreamer, completely out of touch with reality. But I don't know. Down here, I was free. I was in control. No one told me where to go or what to do. The only bad part about it was having to come back up to the real world.
Aww. Oh, that's actually really sad. I hate that. Aww.
Back when we were kids, life was so much easier. You could go from bug collector in the morning to bank robber before bedtime. Anything was possible. Then came high school.
Yeah, same here.
And everyone got brainwashed. People started seeing you the way they wanted to see you. Be the brain, be the clown, be the troublemaker, be popular. People would define you in the most convenient way. And then, that's who you are. They say that when you grow up, something inside you dies. I'm still not sure if that's good or bad. When you're a child, shadows seem darker and lights seem brighter. Everything is more terrifying and more exciting at the same time.
Okay. Jesus Christ. Oh, am I feeling the shinobi? I'm feeling the shinobi. I'm feeling it. Oh, I see what he's doing. Oh, my bad. Well, I learned a little too late, but that's alright. I'm not very good with quick references, can you tell? I'm in love with the art. Look at this. I know I keep saying that, but goddamn. Oh hell. Oh, I didn't know I could do that. Well,
I didn't know I could do that. Now I know. Am I at the beginning?
Yeah, I'm at the beginning. Or am I?
Ooh. I went the wrong way.
Okay. Are there no continues for this one? Ability at? Ooh. How do I do my ability? Well, I can't do it now, but... Ooh, shit! Uh-oh. Awesome. What the fuck? This is actually really goddamn cool. Oh, oops. I actually couldn't see these little bubbles against the water. was trying to decide what to do in a split second, and I decided to do neither. I'm not even mad. God damn it. I don't know why I didn't think about that. Oh, fuck that. No, I'm good. No. Does this slow me down? Yup. Alright. Oh, God. Ah, hell. I saw it happening and I still... Thank you. so much fun. I can't describe to y'all how much fun I'm actually having. I was just gonna do a quick look at this, but this is great. This is amazing. This reminds me of, what was its name? Spirited Away. No Faith? I don't think his name was but that's the only way I kinda like remember his name. Totally based off that? Yeah, 100%. I love it. I love the design. I love, love, love it. I'm so here for this shit. Like, I don't care where it came from, honestly. I would probably love it regardless, because they... Oh. This shit is fucking bomb. And the music, you hear this shit? That's how close I was to this point? Damn it. Oh. Fucking, oh my god. Oh no, that was it? Oh. All right. Oh, my controllers. Acted a fool. Sorry, hang on.
I used to love the weekends. Watching cartoons on early morning TV without a care in the world. The whole family together, free to do whatever we wanted to. Going for long rides in our car, me falling asleep in the back seat, and getting carried to bed when we got home. But then this thing with Dad happened, and now I wasn't sure our family would ever be able to put the pieces back together. Being home alone with Mom, watching her too fall apart. I couldn't stand it. I had to go somewhere. Anywhere. I just had to get out. I used to fantasize about the city, vaguely planning my escape, but never actually getting on the train. Instead, I kept hanging around at the video store, seeking comfort and made up stories where I could pretend I was someone else. Mom would always tell me to quit dreaming and get back into the real world. I couldn't care less. That night at the arcade, everything changed.
I do this. What? Before I do this, hold on. What? Oh, yo, what the fuck? I love this. What the fuck? Thank you. This is so good, dude. This is so fucking great. Just threatening to get up. Oh shit. I'm doing it! Ah! Hang on. I have a question. There are not. Alright, that's all I need to know. I was gonna look for subtitles, but I'm pushing! Push button to get up, push button to get up. I'm trying! I don't like what's happening with this game.
Thank you.
It hurts. Oh, I don't like this. You see that? It says it hurts on the bottom left. Fear ahead. I don't know if I'm just as bad or if I'm not supposed to beat the dragons. But I think I know where this is going.
Thank you.
break free. My own way. She knows. Very concerned. This is in the map that's in the top left, but I went the wrong way. My bad. At least I thought I could go this way. Thank you. Wait, hang on. Can I go through this? Dargan. I feel really uncomfortable. It's really sad. I feel really sad. I feel really sad playing this one. I'm looking for you. But where have I not explored yet? I swear. Go back. If I go back here. Alright, I've already explored that way. And I keep thinking I found like an unexplored area because you see on the map where it has the little dots that are incomplete. But those are places I've been, they're just glitching out, so I can't see them. So every time I turn somewhere, I'm like, oh, I did get that, so it's throwing me off a little bit. I swear I'm not goofing, y'all. I just don't know where I'm supposed to go right now. I went somewhere, right? It did something different with the text. Y'all know what that said? It was binary. It probably just said help, 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 but I'm not sure. There's a path up there, but I can't get there. I don't know how to get there. Going in a circle again. So if any of y'all know which way I'm supposed to go, let me know, because at this point I'm kind of lost. I thought that the map would be broken enough for me to cross that threshold, but that didn't happen, so now I'm confused. I literally don't know where I'm supposed to go. There? What? That's weird. Okay. It wasn't here before, but sure. There we go.
I'm sorry, what?
Is this a reference to, oh, what is that game called? System Shock.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah, okay, Mom.
What happened that night, I honestly couldn't say. I was still there, but nothing was the same.
Wait, what?
Not over. It was just beginning.
You better not tell me that was the whole game. Expecting it to way harder, and I loved it. Oh my god, yo, my controller's losing his shit. Sorry, goddamn amazing. Listen, I don't know what to tell you. Everything about this is great. Everything about this is great. The music, the art, the story. It didn't even need a whole hell of a lot. It just needed enough, and that was enough, and that was great. But I still want more! I still want more of it! I can't wait! It's been a long time since a game got me that hyped for another one. A long time. That's fucking amazing. And it was so short! It was so short! God, that was good! This was a Kickstarter game? Holy shit! Do they have more? I can't check right now. Hang on. Where's my phone? What was their name? Hybit Studios. Are y'all gonna make more? Let me see. I see their Kickstarter here. Hang on. Do I have any more? I'm looking to see if they have anything else. I don't see anything else from them, but... Oh, damn! Did they make, like, an actual arcade thing? Holy shit. Fucking bravo. Holy shit. I wasn't expecting to be up in my fucking feelings tonight, but I guess here we are. Damn. And I got this in a Humble Bundle, so it wasn't... This was not expected, but I'm so glad I decided to finally play it. I'm so glad. I've been looking at it. It's been staring at me for days, weeks on end. I'm so glad. This shit was so good. I can't tell you how good this was. Definitely worth it, but you know. Detroit Become Video Game. You get out of here. Oh, did you see that Detroit Become Human is on Steam now? Detroit Become Human, Horizon Zero Dawn is on Steam. I think I saw a couple others that was on PS4 that are on Steam now. It punched me in the gut. Like, what the hell are these doing here? They must have signed... I think Eel and I were talking about that recently. That he said that they might have signed, like, a super major deal or something. Kind of hype with how much stuff has gone on. Yeah. So I did sit and watch Cup and Noodle stream. When I want to just sit and chill with a streamer, I chill with Cup and Noodle these days. And she was going to play a Deadly Premonition, but before she did that, she watched the Xbox unveil. I don't know what that's called, but the, you know, where you see all the new exclusive games coming out and all that shit. And they've got some good ones coming out. They've got some interesting ones. Well, I wouldn't say good, because, you know, I don't want to get burned. But, you know, Rare has another game coming out now. Which I will 100% say I am unabashedly all for it, because it is definitely a fantastic looking game called Everwild. If you look at it, you'll be like, yeah, this is a glitchy game, 100%. Thank you for playing. No, thank you. Holy shit. This was great. This was fucking amazing. But I guess we're done. I guess that's it. I'm kind of sad I finished it so quick. I didn't know it was going to be that short. Holy hell. What a great game!